They're almost 5 points behind number three, Texas Tech University. Last year, the Hokies' score actually dropped about 2.5 points from the prelim to the finals. I think one thing all the coaches would like to see is an improvement from day one, even though that score doesn't count other than the aforementioned 45-second game day chant, which is a tenth of the score.
Well, that's what makes a two-day competition really difficult. It really shows if the teams can handle the pressure when it counts. There are a couple stunts that went down there. And, of course, handling the elements of this environment outside. Wind coming right off the ocean, sun in their eyes.
The Hokie Bird. Of their squad of 20, half of the team is brand new.
So that's never ever competed.
Obstacle. Wow.
And then walking into this environment can be very intimidating.
This event started here in Daytona Beach in 1996. Ricky Hill was then a coach at James Madison University, and they won the first ever championship here at Daytona. The event itself dates back to the early 80s, 32 years ago in Dallas.
And oh, how cheerleading has changed.
Yeah.
Nice combination passes, finishing with full twists.
Mandy Moore, Kim Smith, Scott Moran, and Berdinga, the captains. But the coach made a good point when he said, this is their reward. They cheer for football and basketball at Virginia Tech. The dance team will be around at the soccer, volleyball, wrestling opportunities. But this is their chance to take center stage and be the star of the show, if you will.
Well, they are stars here, that is for sure. This place is packed with people that love cheerleading. And for Virginia Tech, this is such a special moment because unlike a lot of schools here, their school fully funds them coming to this competition. Wow. Is in full support of their cheerleading squad having their moment. Few mistakes there in those partner stunts. Finishing it out strong, though. Oh, yeah.